Hello everyone, my name is Sergey, and I am the head of production at Frogwares, the studio behind Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1. Today is a huge day for us, one that we waited for ages. It's the day in which Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1 is out and available for you to play. Now, before you start your adventure with solving mysteries, finding clues, and exploring Cordona, take a look at our 6 tips that will come handy during your journey as the young and brash Sherlock Holmes. New 6 tips to help you be a better detective in Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1 November 16, 2021 Ekman 0 Comments Chapter Detective Holmes Sherlock Tips. Hello everyone, my name is Sergey, and I am the head of production at Frogwares, the studio behind Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1. Today is a huge day for us, one that we waited for ages. It's the day in which Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1 is out and available for you to play. Now, before you start your adventure with solving mysteries, finding clues, and exploring Cordona, take a look at our 6 tips that will come handy during your journey as the young and brash Sherlock Holmes. 1. Use the new disguise system. Thanks to this new mechanic that we introduced to our series, with the right attire, you might be able to get more valuable information to help solve your case. You just have to remember one thing: people like to judge others based on first impressions. If you look the part, they might not be as willing to share secrets with you. Look like someone they can trust, and all of a sudden, they will tell you more than you bargained for. A barman at a local hangout that's a favorite among sailors will be less reluctant to give you more info if you come dressed as a sailor, as opposed to looking like a fancy suited up gentleman. So plan your clothing carefully before you head out to someone or somewhere. Local shops and merchants at markets are the places where you can get those outfits for any occasion. 2. Combat. If you're ever ambushed, you can use more than just your wits to get out of a tricky situation. However, remember that you're a glass cannon, not a killing machine. So use your wits when you engage in combat. Use the environment around you to your advantage. And whatever you do, try to avoid killing people. Disarming a foe will do the trick. If you end up killing too many enemies around you, it will start impacting your dear friend John, who doesn't like people losing their lives for no reason. Remember though, if you're not a fan of gunfights and hand-to-hand combat, you can turn combat off in the game settings. You can then devote all your time to sleuthing. Your game's progress or story will not suffer in any way, you just won't have to use your muscle power. We leave that choice to you. 3. Try to be as thorough as you can while combing over the crime scene. Sometimes, the most important clues will not present themselves to you on a plate. You might have to look around a bit more carefully when you snoop around so that you do not miss out on anything important. You might come across some vital evidence that may exonerate some suspect, like a letter found in a desk drawer, or you might find some more details that don't add up on the person who claims they were not around the scene. Keep in mind that in Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1, you can convict the wrong person, but there won't be a game over screen. You'll just have to learn to live with your consequences. And the people you convict need to live with them too. 4. It is okay to feel stuck. Even the greatest detective of all time, yet, I'm talking about Sherlock Holmes here, was stuck on a case. So it's okay for you to be stuck too. A good way to find that aha moment is take a look at the evidence that you haven't seen. If they might be leading you somewhere. Perhaps you just need a little bit more info that's missing. Scour through places that might give you that missing info. Looking for an address of a particular individual, maybe the police station has it. There was a certain case that made quite a bit of headlines at one time. Maybe the local newspaper has old news pieces in its archives from the time. Just look at the resources and services available to you. A visit to them might be just what you need to do. 5. Make sure you explore the island carefully. The island of Cordona is worth exploring. Apart from its views, shops, and people, there are also some interesting side quests around that will be unveiled to you only if you come across them. Keep your eyes wide open wherever you go. Listen to the chatter in the crowd, look at posters on the walls. All of those could be an entry to a rabbit hole of a new investigation. Besides side quests, you can also find specialized furniture dealers. You can use the wares that they sell to furnish your family home. After all, there's nothing more satisfying than to bring back the Holmes mansion to its former glory. And like I mentioned earlier, you can also buy clothes from merchants too. So keep your eyes and ears open, detective. You never know what you might stumble across. 6. Mind Palace, the place where you arrange your thoughts. This is the place where you piece it all together. All the clues, all the evidence, and all the scenarios. Take some time and spend it here. See all the possibilities and scenarios that are unveiling to you. And if you see your train of thought broken, perhaps see if you can find a clue that's missing. This is the place where you shine the most. Thank you so much for spending some time with me, and I hope that these tips will be of some use to you. Enjoy your adventure, detective. There's plenty of mysteries that are waiting to be uncovered in Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1. And if you buy the game today, you will also receive the full game Sherlock Holmes, Crimes and Punishments for free, along with extra Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1 in-game content. This offer only lasts for a week, so take a look at it now before you miss out. Good luck and speak to you. Please visit us. GameMastral.org. Full article in the description. Thanks for watching.